play the word with me and you'll be able to click when I'm on the desk. But hey. Yeah, for whatever reason, that's real common with this setup. I've got my microphone blasted to 100, always. But the game audio always drowns it out. Yeah, the game audio always drowns it out. I'm very sorry about that. Usually I have that fixed before I get started. But this is a brand new game, so I hadn't really messed with the settings yet. My apologies. Alright, so let's get in here. Crank down the audio. The other thing is I'm incredibly hard of hearing. But hey everybody, how's it going? How's everybody doing this afternoon? Evening, wherever you're at. Over here on the West Coast, we're approaching 4 o'clock, so I assume it's evening in most cases. Hey Frodo, Hilton, Peter. How's that sound? Does that sound a little bit better, guys? Thank you again. Okay, so this is called My Night Job. My Night Job is brand new and just came out on Steam today. And I was given a key to mess around with it, so I figured why not mess around with it live and just figure out the game live. You can see my reactions to it, your reactions to it. Please feel free at any point to ask questions about the game, make comments about the game, suggestions about the game. I know I appreciate them, and oftentimes I've seen the developers and publishers end up in here, and they take those suggestions to heart, and they do good things with them, so. But most importantly, thank you all for coming, and I hope you guys are having a great evening, or afternoon, wherever you are. You know, I'll get that fixed someday. I gotta find the perfect level for that. I really do. Is the game volume still too loud for everybody? Because that's gonna be important to me. that will drive me nuts. It amazes me that I can have my microphone set to 100 and my game volume set to like 10. And the game volume still drowns it out. Is that a sound card thing? You'd think I'd know more about computers, but I really don't. I know the basics, that's about it. Thank you. Thank you, Frodo. Thank you, Hilton. Thank you, Peter. Let's go help a cheerleader. Oh, let's go see if we can pick anything up first. Look, we can go down, we can go up. Okay, so this is just gonna be like a little beat-em-up. Alright. I bet you I'd be better service using my controller for a game like this. Here we go. Alright. No, I'm gonna dig out the controller here. Oh, nope. Let's not do that. Well, this doesn't seem like anything too fancy too far. Just standard side-scrolling, beating him up, but of course it's probably just breaking me in easy, I hope. No tricks. Bad dogs. Bad dogs. Get that rat, man. Jeez, there we go. Yeah, I think it is a sound card issue, too. He's got a shotgun. That's what I want. Where'd you find out, buddy? What's in there? We found the nurse. Wow. Just wow, game. Really? I want this. Can I have this? Oh, I can have this! Okay, now we're talking. Yeah, let's go up the stairs here. I have chainsaw. I am a happy guy. This will entertain me for a while. Oh, I see. We can dig. Oh, we can keep digging. You can get more than one thing out of here. Can we give them to people, or do people just have their own thing? I like discovering new games. Trying to figure out what the hell is going on. Oh, I think I cleared the level, but I don't think I wanted to clear the level. I bet you there was more stuff I could find. Oh, okay, I just got them out of there. Oh, okay. Alrighty. I need a key. Go find a key. It's funny because the majority of the people I know on the internet are not from the United States. Peter and Echo are two of the exceptions. What's going on up here? That doesn't look good. That doesn't look good. Does it tell me I can't go that way? Because of the explosion? Ooh, I died. I was reanimated. Oh no, that was handy. Oh my god, are these like crazy monkeys too? I don't think I'm doing very well. I was doing well, and then now I don't think I'm doing as well. I got a clown. This is just very strange so far. Can I save her? Oh my god, that thing is gonna kill me. Can I like... I don't like that thing. So it's real late for you guys over there. Almost midnight, huh? Just creeping on midnight. Rip. Grade D. Oh, I know what I have to put here. Even though metal's not here, I'll put it anyway. I am Gia. Well, that was interesting. Let's give that another shot. I mean, surely there's some little mechanics I'm missing here and there. Rescue 100 people. Defend all the room. Okay, I see. I see. Okay. Let's go downstairs this time. There's stuff to do down here too, I'll bet. What's up here? Nothing? Nothing? So do I just have to go back and find the people I haven't found? Or that died? Oh, here they all are. Is this all them? Come here. Let's go, people. Oh, is there something over here, too? Or is that just pointing at the box? I think he's just pointing at the box. Oh, there's people to help over here, too. We gotta help everybody. Oh, we're gonna have, like, a whole squad. So can we play this multiplayer? Oh my god, that would be just insane. That's probably asking too much, huh? Am I not supposed to be here? Is that why it's black and white? What in the world? Is the devil churning butter? The devil is churning butter. That's a gargoyle. or a manticore or some shit that's trying to kill me. That devil is churning the butter, though. Like, for real. That devil is working that butter. Alright. That's interesting. Let's go back to where I was telling you to go. Nothing there? Run, everybody. Follow the arrows. Humorous, but a standard beat-em-up nonetheless so far. I take it these explosions aren't good, though. I think they block off certain rooms, maybe? No, 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 go back down. We're good. So now I see a red room right... Oh, I need to go to that red room, maybe, and defend that room? That room under attack? Oh, okay. I get it. These rooms are turning yellow, and they need to be defended. That one now. Okay, yeah, the zombies have taken over that room, so we need to go defend it. Okay, I figured it out. Okay, so it's not just mindless beat-em-up. Hold on, let's go help these guys. We're gonna need their help. Come with us. There's like a whole bunch of weird people here we need to go defeat. Come on. We gotta take this room back over. I get it. I get it. So I gotta take these rooms back over. I gotta make them all safe from the zombie overlord people thingies. No, get here. Nope. Nope. No takeovers. We will not have takeovers on my watch. We have eliminated a threat. Okay, but upstairs. Upstairs. Ooh, outside. Jesus. I take it outside's bad, and I should probably just avoid outside in general, maybe? Just come out here and kill him anyway. Oh, nope. Taking over. We can't leave anybody behind. We gotta rescue everybody that says help, though. Are we carrying too many people? Is that why they keep leaving us? I don't understand. Help me! I know what that means now, though. That means we gotta go upstairs, and we gotta defend this room, because it has been taken over by these zombies. Zombies! And cult-looking guys and stuff. Cultists! No, 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 give me back the chainsaw. I wish I could arm these people. I should be able to arm these people. You guys need to be armed, too. And I got different... Oh, I can't go that way at all. I get it. So that room's blocked, and the only way to get to that room is going to be this way. By the time I get there, they're taking over other rooms. Can I, oh, so that's it. Can I go leave people in rooms to defend them? Maybe I should quit carrying them all with me, yeah. No, but I need to rescue 100 people too, so that doesn't make sense. Alright, come on guys. We're clear. Get up these stairs. Look, there's shit going down. Darby, sheets going down. Thank you. Oh shit, my weapon's gone. My weapon. I need a weapon. Give me a weapon. There we go. I am El Kabong. I am El Kabong. Oh, well, that was brutally efficient, but we can't get in there. We're going, we're going, we're going. Alarm, I know. No. Get. Got it. Who you gonna call? So how do we get down to the other... Oh, what's that? Oh, I can get people rescued there. Yeah, rescue people. How do I get out? There we go. There we go. That's 10? That's 10? Boy, I need to get to work. Alright, I'm a tenth of the way to my goal. And they are really taking over now. Jesus. I don't think I thought this one through. Well, I can't go. I'm trying to go through a wall. No matter how much I dash, I won't really go through the wall. I wonder why. I don't need anything other than a shot. Hey. I don't think so, zombie. You either doggy. Zombie doggy. Hey, Brian, how you doing out there? Welcome to the party. We're trying a brand new game today. I'm gonna throw a fucking statue. Hell yeah. It's called my night job. Apparently I am clearing this place of some zombies. I'm saving some people. Nice little indie platform type thing going on. Hey, zombies. I don't think so. Oh, I went crazy. Am I Jekyll and Hyde? Oh, that's kind of awesome. I did not know that. I mean, I can't go up the stairs right there. I really wanted to go up the stairs right there. There we go. I'm doing well. Just trying out this little game here. Got a couple more I'd like to try out tonight, hopefully. Just kind of messing around. I know I got all kinds of rooms that are being taken over. And in this one, I'm basically trying to take my rooms back over from these zombies here. I assume I'm some sort of security guard. You know me, I'm doing that thing where I like to go into a game completely blind and figure it out. I thought it was just a standard beat-em-up at first, but no, this is actually a lot of fun. There's some strategy involved, sort of. Ooh, this damn robot. Oh my god, there's a million of them. These things are hard! How did we get up here? Is that Slimer? Is that Slimer? Help me out, Slimer. Dude, the roof is infested with, like, the hard guys. And it's a lot harder without a weapon. Boy, it's a lot harder without a weapon. Need a weapon. There we go. No. Don't go up. I don't want to go up. Go back down. A lot of scary shit up there. Save some people. And we will move forward. Oh, you can use the bike. Oh, the cat was awesome. The cat is with us. All right. The cat just took a bunch of things out. I'm sure Manic would have liked that if he'd have seen it. Oh, you guys want to go this way? Let's go this way. I want to go down. Is there a way to go down? Like, I'm losing parts of my house, man. We're never going to be able to leave, bruh. They've done it. They've destroyed enough of the house. Rip. Wow, so this is pretty hard. I walked in expecting something easy. Oh my god, everybody messaged me at once, sorry. I'll catch up with everybody shortly. So any opinions on this game by anybody so far? Anybody got any opinions on this one? I'd like to hear some opinions. Mine so far, the graphics aren't too bad. I like that it's got controller support. And I think once I get the hang of it, I can see where it's a lot of fun. Boy, it's going to be hard to defend all these rooms though. And rescue 100 people. You got to rescue 100 people also. A little counter right there next to the map. That's your 0 of 100. You got to rescue 100 people. Finding that to be difficult. But of course, I'm slowly understanding the game better too. So that goes a long way. Be scared, dude. I'm just trying to find more people to save before I drop you off at the helicopter. I know all you want to do is go to the helicopter. Go. Run to the helicopter then. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh yeah, no helicopter. All Cobra Command style. Bam. Save 5 of them. Got me a shotgun for it. See, now that I get the mechanics of the game, it makes a lot more sense. Nothing in there. Her. Why would I put down a shotgun for a tree? Hey. No, come on, girls. Look, see? Save. Just like that. Two more. Bam, bam. Starting to get it now. This isn't too bad. Oh, it is when you don't have a weapon though. Jeez. Gotta get, oh, look, look. Gotta have a weapon. Boy, this game can be brutal without a weapon. Chainsaw. Yeah, it's rough when most of my viewers are from that side of the world, and it's very late for you all by the time I'm getting home from work and getting on, isn't it? That explains why I don't have anybody while I'm on at 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock. But when I start at 6 o'clock in the morning, I get a lot of viewers. And I'm starting to realize why. I think the majority of my viewers are from overseas. which I welcome, gratefully. Frankly, I think you guys have better taste than we do anyway. Oh no! But I'm trying to work out a proper time that I think is good for my being able to be viewed. I did, late night for a while, but I mean, I work mornings, so that's a little difficult. But I have done, before I go to work, I've done streams, and that seems to work sometimes, actually. If I can stream an hour or two before work. Because then that makes it afternoon overseas. And again, like I said, when I do, you know, 6 o'clock in the morning on Sundays and Saturdays, that always does well. No matter what channel I do for. No, 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 no. We can't let too many of these rooms get taken over, though. New weapon. Go. We gotta go take our rooms back. Come on. No, I know you want to leave, but we gotta go take our rooms back first. So their orange arrow is them telling me where they want to go for a helicopter. And that's all well and dandy, but I got rooms to save first. We gotta save these rooms. If we lose 4 rooms, we die. I notice that. So we can't lose any of our rooms in the process. No, you guys cannot leave yet until everything's dead around here. We go downstairs. Can we go downstairs? We need to go downstairs. Ah, right there. I see the stairs. I had no weapon. There we go. Give me my house back. Or at least the place I'm securing. Whatever it is. Oh my god, I have no weapon. Hey, you guys have weapons. You can go up there, you know. You don't need me. Save that guy. We're gonna leave the child behind. Don't leave the child behind. Why is he saying bye? I can only carry so many at a time, though. Alright, I get it. I get it. Get out of here. Okay, we've got 20. But boy, are we in some bad shape. This house is getting taken over. Come on, guys. I can't do this alone. No! Okay, we lost that room. I'm just booking it to get to these rooms before I lose them. There we go. No, don't do that. Now we gotta go down to the next one. Where's the next one? Here, get out of here. How do I get down to the next one? I gotta go up, over, down, down. Oh my god, I'm never gonna make it. You're all gonna die. No way to go that way. Here's my trophies though. Down these stairs. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. We gotta go down these stairs. Come on, quit crying. Bring the axe, go down the stairs. Kill things, because I'm gonna die. We gotta go turn all these off. Difficult. You gotta make all the red floors green and rescue 100 people. Did I die? Okay. Does the health... Do the rooms regain health? That's becoming my question now. Like, I see everything that's going on. I get it. Those rooms have health bars and everything. So I can tell which ones I need to get to. Like, the roof mostly right now. But I'm gonna lose the roof. Does green mean it's actually going back up though? I think green means it's going back up. I think yellow means it's just staying flat, and green means it's going back up. But I'm not sure. Oh shit. And that means I lose a floor. So I do get all that. I'll see all that. I know it all that, yeah. Nothing. Boy, we're in bad shape, though. Because they're going to take the roof out. Well, they just took out the part I was going to. They just took out the part I was going to. Oh, thank you for the host, Care Bear. And thank you all out there in Twitterland for all the tweets, the retweets, and the love. And thank you, Charlotte, for coming by. Sorry that you lost your internet there, hon. And sorry about the audio problems at the beginning. Hopefully they've resolved somewhat. But so far so good on this little thing here. My Night Job. My Night Job. Just came out on Steam. And it seems really neat. I'm having a lot of fun with it, especially as I'm figuring things out. Basically, what I need to do is save 100 of these people off this floor while also saving the house itself. And if the house itself, obviously if it collapses, you lose. It seems to be four, if you lose four levels, four rooms, then you lose the house. So you have to strategize where you're going. And they all seem to have little health bars, so while they're green, they're good. And the red, obviously, you need to get over there. They're in danger. I like how it's working out so far. Alright, but I do like that it's got the full controller support. Full controller support is always A+. rescue 100 people, defend all the rooms. We get their little green health bars. 'Cause I figured there had to be an order to what rooms I was going to, but it's taken me a minute to figure all that out. No, honey, you're not leaving yet. We're going to rescue a few people. We're going to gather some weapons. There's little tiny elements of this and that here and there, but nothing major. I like it. It's accessible for a casual player. Like, you do not have to be hardcore to be able to play this, obviously, because I'm not a hardcore... Like, I'm a gamer. I like to game, but, I mean, I'm not major league by any stretch of the imagination. I suck at Call of Duty. Rocket League I'm good at. But I love these indie games. And we're going to have a nice little big group that we're going to take with us. And it seems like as we take them to their little helipad, like we'll take this whole little group to the helipad. And I'm gathering points. Points, 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 money, guns, ammo. Hey, I don't think I got a shotgun that time, though. Kind of disappointed in that. No, you're coming with me, kid. I grab the statue. We're gonna go. We'll be buds. No. Back up here. Yeah. Oh, great. Another kid. Even if your whiny kid's following me. I can say that about because I have kids, and none of my kids are whiny. I get his shotgun though, right? I've been waiting for the shotgun, really. Oh, I got HP that time. I'll take it. Okay, up here is hardcore, right? I don't want to be up here. Yeah, I just wanted a weapon. I'm down. Don't worry. Okay, a wrench is better than an umbrella. Or is that a pickaxe? That's a big ass crate and that does some damage. Uh-oh, here we go. Now we're gonna start losing rooms. Okay, this is what it's all about here. So we gotta go save that room, right? And how we do that is to follow the little maze thing here. Oh shit. Nope, wrong one. Oh yes, we could get there. Can we get there from there? I don't think we can. We gotta get there from here. Oh no, we can't get there from here. We can't drop down. Guys. Oh shit, guys. We got a problem. You're all free. You don't need help. Kill the zombie. Oh no, we're all gonna die. I went the wrong way. Oh god, we're all gonna die. Come on, we gotta hurry up, guys. I'll come back to you later. I got a world to save. I went too far to save the world. There we go. This room. I gotta fuck about the health of my rooms and I don't appreciate none. Oh, you guys think you're funny, huh? Grab this real quick. Smash some fucking zombies' heads in. Like, they stopping. We're jumping up and down like children. My kids don't even behave like that. That's what they're doing. They're like bad poltergeists. They're like just trying to break the floors. It's horrible. Evil, rotten, evil spirits. Malevolent doesn't even begin to cover it. to malevolent spirits tend to be clever. You guys are jerks, man. Where now? Above us? Clear this one. A lot of people do this. Let me turn it red real quick. Well, we gotta get over there. We got a room in trouble. We got rooms in trouble. Panic, disarray. Guys, I can't be the only... Look, guys. Me being the only one killing just doesn't help. I need your cooperation. Like, especially you. Dude, you have an axe. It's got blood on it. Obviously, you've been using it for something. Are they just licking him? This is like the worst zombies ever. They're like, we don't really know what to do. We're like noob zombies. All we know how to do is like lick people and pound the ground to try and destroy your house. We brought our zombie dogs with us. Oh shit, I need to go down. Hey guys. No, give me the shotgun. Shotgun. Oh, whoa, that's far. That was dead. That was way deader than I intended to be. Good one. Good death. How long was that run? Only 7 minutes? I got a new high score though. Go Gia. Go Gia. Metal would be proud. Took care of that real quick. So how is everybody doing this positive evening? It's creeping towards evening for me, finally. Oh, they had 11 people that are even on right now. Frodo came over to say hi anyways. Frodo, you're so kind. You are awesome for having had come by. See, we're still not cracking. We're just barely cracking into 10. We can't even make it into 20 minutes. 20 minutes, we should be able to survive longer is what it's telling me. Check out those names though. I like the names. Ash is my favorite at 7. But I mean, come on. Freddy Krueger, Michael Myers, Chucky. Good stuff on there, guys. Alrighty. Well, that was pretty cool. I've got other things I want to check out while we're here. Kind of wanted to mess around with this a little bit. It does start tomorrow. It gets released tomorrow. I'm not sure if there's a embargo on it though. So we might check out this Dust Bowl a little bit. I haven't played Dust Bowl yet. So what do we have here is another post-apocalyptic adventure game set in a world where the player must search for food, water, and essential supplies. Ooh, that's even a little more hardcore survival. You see, the game we were just playing, in case you all wanted to check out the store page and see what it looks like, is this right here. My Night Job. And I gotta be honest, I kinda like this one. I'm a little iffy on the price point, but I think that's just because I, in my limited ability, haven't been able to unlock everything that I should be able to. I'll be honest with you there. I think it's my limitation more than anything else so far. I'm going to give it another go. I do. Just looking at it makes me want to give it another go. Give it another go. I think it works really well with the controller. I hear cars beeping outside or like that real quick. Okay, so what do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It looks like there's 10 trophies too. So for you achievement hunters and you trophy hunters out there, that might appeal to you. Me, I'm not so worried about the achievements. I mean, I think it's cool when I get them. Don't get me wrong. I'm not downplaying them. I'm not like some, oh, this is an achievement. But it's really, really, really cool for some people. And I get that. And that's what they play the games for. I got people that are friends of mine that literally, that's what they play for. They want 100% everything. Or like on the PlayStation, what they call platinuming things and stuff like that. But it's definitely not my thing. All I like to do is dig in and enjoy a game. But if I notice, hey, I've got 2 trophies. I do dig it. I'm not going to lie. It feels like I've accomplished something. You know what I mean? A sense of accomplishment. That's the phrase I'm looking for. I feel a sense of accomplishment. But it's not necessary for me. But for those of you that do, that are the trophy hunters or the achievement types, there you go. One second, please. I have to fill a form out. And after this, I wanted to check out Jalopy, but I need to look up and make sure that there isn't an embargo going on. And if there's not, I'll stream some Jalopy because I was having a lot of fun with that the other day with my, when my friend was here. And ironically enough, he was drinking vodka. I wasn't. but he was, and it was actually pretty funny. But, oh wow, that's gonna take me a minute. Yeah, I'll fill that out in a little bit. That's just gonna take me a second to fill out, and I don't want to hold everybody up. I want to continue with my night job real quick. I need my secretary. Where is she? That's what she's supposed to be here for, to do that for me. No, I don't want to erase it. I want to keep it going. I think this is even something like my kids would enjoy. Like, don't get me wrong. I'm not talking about like giving kids the gory game. Like, I have a teenage daughter. She's old enough to handle this. I think she'd enjoy it quite a bit. Because it's kind of fun. It's going to take me a while to build up the skill to be able to save 100 of these guys and the house. I feel like I could do one or the other. But it's going to take me a minute to be able to build up the ability to do saving the house and saving 100 people. That's a lot. And then I get scared like that and I accidentally hit people I shouldn't. But thankfully it doesn't hold that against you. Because, I mean, really, if it did, I'd be screwed. But I guess in this kind of game, I really can't. I just wish the supporting characters were a little more helpful. Like, you could arm them. Even if it was just, like, a handful of them. Like, I get, okay, maybe the cheerleaders, they don't want to get involved. But this guy right here with the hoodie, like, grab a guitar, bud. Like, hook it up. Grab a guitar. Get your thing done. Like, it's not that hard. And I seen the guy, like, the guy with the axe. Does he even wield that axe at anybody, or is he just, like, a jerk store? Walking around with a bloody axe that he's not going to do anything with, look, and I can look at my trophies. Does that do anything? I wonder if that does something, if I activate a trophy. Ooh, I bet you that does. Oh, so maybe they've actually given me a reason to hunt down some achievements because I can collect those trophies and maybe get some form of power-up from them. Now that would be a good way to get someone like me a little more involved with hunting down the trophies. Pretty smart, if that's the case. And you know, I was going at this relentlessly and just going through like a beat-em-up and kind of bashing and everything. You gotta have a little more style and strategy than that, I've noticed. You definitely need a little more style and strategy than that. But I like that. I think that's huge. Okay, now here's this is where it gets difficult, but kind of fun. I kind of like this. I just wish it wasn't as hard to get to some of the rooms. I really think that's what I'm struggling with more than anything, is just how I'm getting to some of the rooms. I gotta fucking... There's like this dead spot in the middle that you can't get from one room to the other, like one side to the other, you know what I mean? And I'm not in good shape. I need help. There we go. Now we're in good shape. And I think that's why some of these weapons are so OP. I thought they were a little overpowered at first. I really did. And I could see why. Because by the time you get to a room that's that crazy, you need to be able to take out 4 or 5 of the zombies before your thing breaks. And it's inevitably going to break, like it's supposed to. And your weapon should have durability like that, especially since you're using catch-all type stuff. So I think the balance is there. I kind of like the balance. If you're wondering, this is literally how I would go about reviewing a game. But this is how I feel a game out for myself. I play around with it. If you've been watching from the beginning, lurking around or whatever, you've heard me sway a little and be like, oh, this is just an old-fashioned beat-em-up. This is boring. And now, like, as I pick up different elements of the game, I realize what I'm playing, and I start to like it more or dislike things more. And this is how I go about reviewing a game. I like to kind of go in blind. I don't really want to read somebody else's review of the game. I want to avoid watching other YouTube videos or clips or Let's Plays or anything like that. Even if I can avoid the trailer of the game. I like to read what the game is, of course. I don't want to go in completely stupidly blind. I need to know that, oh, no wonder that thing's attacking me. It's a man-eating plant. Awesome. Like, I want to know what I'm playing. That's how I knew it was sort of a beat-em-up. But I don't like going too in-depth because I like to be surprised and I like to feel things out for myself. And I think the best way that that's going to convey is if I start doing these live reviews as opposed to the 5-minute reviews I've been doing on YouTube. I think this gets across my feel for a game a lot more because I get a lot of questions all the time. Is that genuinely how you feel about that, or that just sounds like something you read in another review or something like that? And I can understand that because there is a lot of reviews out there. But I think if you just watch me organically go through this process, you'll start to realize exactly what it is that I do and how it is that I look at things. But I'll be honest, like, since we're talking about it, especially so candidly like that, this is a good example. In the beginning, I fired it up and I started thinking, okay, this is just a generic beat-em-up. It's fun. It's something I could see me spitting like an hour or two into and then just being sick of and never playing again. However, having slowly gone through about 3 or 4 different little, 10-minute playthroughs, and now a couple little 5-minute playthroughs, I start to get a feel for exactly what I'm supposed to be doing, when and where and how. And it makes a lot of sense, and I'm kind of liking this. Like, you got to defend parts of the house, and you save the house, and the house's hit points go up, and you got to watch your hit points, too, and hence the your night job. And I really, really, really must admit that I like that an awful lot. It's not roguelike. I don't want to say roguelike, because that's not really what it is. It's not like you're carrying anything over. There is the permadeath, obviously. But it's just more like, I don't know, a lot of freaking fun. And a lot more fun than I expected at first. And I think you heard me say right at the beginning, this game wouldn't even be worth about $5. I take that back. I think this game is worth the full price. $7.99 seems very, very fair for this game. I'm definitely getting $7.99's worth of pleasure out of it, joy. I could definitely see me going through this a lot more than I originally expected to, I would say, an hour ago. Too many subscriber attempts for that. Well, here. Lucky for you, my friends. I have another. What do you think of that? So, is there anybody out there that's willing to give their opinion on what they've seen so far? Lurkers aside, by all means, if you're just lurking, please continue to lurk. I never want to call out lurkers. I am a lurker myself. When I'm not streaming, I lurk, and if I'm talking in your stream, you must know I like you, because, I mean, not that I don't like the people that I'm lurking, but I generally don't like to talk in chat rooms, so. I'd like to give a shout out to Wayne over at Free Range Games. I'd like to give him a thank you. Maybe sometime this weekend, you may be watching me do this with another new game coming up. And if you do, I'm going to be very excited, because it's one I've been following on both Twitter and on Steam quite a bit, because I'm a huge board game type fan. Oh, this is going to be awesome. Labyrinth is something I'm definitely interested in. Alright. So I want to play another round of this. I'm getting a good sense of what's going on here. What are the tops going on here? Wow. I'm 29th. Oh, and I'll complain, I guess. That's cool, so there's a world leaderboard, for those of you wondering. What do you think, guys? All in all, I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying it better than I did at the beginning. I figured it just for an old-fashioned beat-em-up. I was mistaken. It's actually a lot more fun than that. So I'm sorry I shortchanged it a little bit there. Let's go downstairs first. Like, there's something I can do here too, it looks like. Which seems kind of cool. Once I figure out what it is I can do there. Yeah, I gotta figure out. I know. Maybe a lamp? Maybe I can put a lamp there? Or a potted plant? Like, I could tell there's more going on than meets the eye now. Because I've experienced a lot more than going on than meets the eye. I can't save this chick? She doesn't seem savable, huh? And I really like all the old school, like, it's not just the horror, it's the old sci-fi style enemies, like the radioactive suits and it. There's like a real B-movie flair to this. That I'm a huge fan of. Oop, chainsaw, love it. I don't think the level is procedurally generated, but this is, I mean, I'm only on the first level. God's sakes, before I say anything about that, I should, you know, be able to pass the first level. And it's not a complaint yet, either. Obviously, being that I'm having issues. Okay, now look, you have an axe. You both have an axe! Can I get a little help here with the axes? Like, I know the guy with the shotgun shotguns. He shotguns. He shoots. X and down. I'm not wasting ammo on you. Give me my shotgun. I do wish I could carry two things. Would be nice to be able to carry two things. Come on, kid. There's zombies that way. There's fucking helicopters this way. Which way do you think I want you to go? Thank you. I'll take the health points. Yeah, I can use that. This chair here. I see a room going yellow, so I'm going to get there before it gets red. Because that's when they start doing crazy stuff to, like, try and knock the floor down. And that's how the house loses health points. Because the house has hit points, too. Oh, I went all Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde. I don't know what causes that. I haven't figured it out yet, but I like it. You like Jekyll and Hyde status. Oh wow, I had to reboot my chat room, sorry. It froze. So if you said anything, I doubt it, but if you did, I do apologize. Apparently my chat room froze. Okay, come on. I'm gonna get you guys to the helicopter. Come on, shotgun dude. I want your shotgun, so come with me so I can get you to the helicopter. Pretty sure I can get your shotgun if I do that. Just tell them I'm doing a good job of keeping it. Gotta keep an eye on the floors. When they go orange, I'm going there. Before they even get red, I'm going there. Shit, I can't get over there. Alright. Oh, give me the nurse. I saw a shark just eat a zombie. Nice. Alright, come on, you guys. You guys get out of here, and I'll go take care of the other thing. Come on, guys! No, 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 no! See what happens when you take too long? Everybody is your friend. Oh god, you can't get through them. Oh look, we saved the butler. Oh, holy shit! This whole floor is in danger. Oh, for the love of God. No, 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 no. Pick up the box. Here we go. This way. And the floor below it. Oh, no, 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 to the right. The bike. I'm gonna do the trunk. I like the trunk better. Same floors. I gotta go take care of those red floors, man. Shit, wrong one. Down. I need to get down. I need to get up with to get down. How do I get down there? Oh god, oh god. Oh, right there. Oh, it may, Oh,
I'm moving especially too. Holy God, they take this house over fast. Sometimes it's not a whole lot of them, so it's like it's not as bad to clear as you think. It's just getting to all the rooms. Getting to all the rooms is what's making it difficult. I am El Caballon. Can I just bail once I start saving them? Because I really don't give a shit about them. That's a trophy room. Shit. There's nowhere to go. I gotta go all the way around. So I'm gonna take the long way around. Come on. Old lady. Well, we got rooms to save. Forgetting about the dash. Straight fucking punching. I need weapons, man. I'm gonna die this way. More I can say for helping with the golf club. Oh my God, the rooms, they won't stop. Oh shit, no, there's one more. Died anyway. Yeah, that was a good run that time. Jeez, man. I got way into that one. Okay, so this is a good game. Definitely quality. I mean, I'm still on a grade D, and I really enjoyed that run. So, I gotta say, first impressions wise, I like this. I'm happy with it. This is something I definitely would consider picking up at the price point that it's at right now, because that's like ridiculously cheap, man. This game is $7.99 right now. It's on sale for like $6.39 because it just got released today. You could do a lot worse, man. Really, it seems simple at first. It's really got a good challenge to it. It's a lot of fun. It's really neat trying to defend the house while you're trying to save all the people. And eventually, I'm gonna get more than 20 people out of this house. You watch. As for right now, I'm going to pause for a moment, refill my coffee, and we're going to come back, and we are going to finally change up the game for real and start up another and see what we got. So I will be right back with another game. Hang tight, 5 minutes at the most. Maybe 10, but I doubt it. I'm looking at 5. I'll turn off the stream and turn it back on, so if you have your notifications set, you'll know when I'm back.